Trinity obviously set off the atomic age, and it was the culmination of, was one of the most extraordinary scientific efforts done at Los Alamos.
During World War II, two entirely different types of weapons were developed. There was the uranium gun type weapon, which was known as Little Boy. There was Batman, which was the plutonium implosion weapon. They were confident enough with Little Boy to send it into combat without a full-scale test. However, Batman, because it was more complicated, they wanted to test it first before they dropped it over enemy territory. I think Oppenheimer in particular knew that not only was this going to potentially end the war, help end the war, but that it was going to change history as well. And of course, you have to think, what if it didn't work? You can imagine what it would be like if we dropped a significant amount of plutonium on enemy territory and it was captured. So that was the pressing concern. It had to work. I think one thing to really consider is that this had never been done before. Nobody had ever conducted a nuclear test. There was no precedent for that. When they were assembling the bomb, the pieces didn't fit together. There was some expansion and contraction with the components, and there were some pretty tense moments. They conducted the test atop a 100-foot steel tower. How do you get a nuclear bomb 100 feet off the ground? Well, it's another very tense operation, just cranking this thing slowly up the tower. One of the reasons why they selected the Trinity site was that it never rains there. And late that night, there was not only rain, but a tremendous thunderstorm, a lightning storm that came through. About 5:30 in the morning, the detonation finally occurs. The Trinity test goes off, and it's a remarkable success.
And it took place and was very impressive. The results were far greater than we expected.
Well, of course, it was an extraordinary experience. We've been working on this thing for a long, long time.
I think I was most impressed by the light that was given. I mean, it really did light up the whole area.
I was looking straight at the right spot. There appeared a very small point of light. And my first impression was, I very distinctly remember, is that all? Then I remembered I had all these glasses, so outside it might be a little bigger.
It was so bright, it simply blinded me. So then I looked over to the left at the Oscuro Mountains, and I saw that they were lit up as though by daylight.
Hoffmeyer looked very relieved, as might be expected. After all, it had worked, and the tension was over.
When they brought in 44, the IBM punch card counting machines, that's when we started actually building what we think of now as scientific computers. And that's what we actually use for the Trinity device, was designing it, was those punch card machines. So it's been key all the way along. The thermonuclear devices that were the U.S. designed right after the Soviets shot their first device, we designed those on all the first generation machines. The United States, the Soviet Union, tested in the atmosphere early on, basically the late 40s for the United States, when the Soviets developed their first atomic bomb in the fall of 1949. From that point forward, the Soviet Union tested in the atmosphere in the 1950s as well. Testing went underground in the 1960s.
I was concerned that the amount of money we were spending in the early days doing experiments in Nevada, compared with the amount of money that we spent in calculations, was entirely out of whack.
After the Soviet Union collapsed, the United States began exploring the feasibility of maintaining the nuclear stockpile without full-scale testing.
2, 1.
The Wizards of Armageddon used to rely on underground nuclear tests to make up for what they didn't know. But the Clinton administration has suspended those tests. So how can the Wizards still be sure the 20,000 weapons that remain in the nuclear stockpile actually work? What happens to a nuclear weapon after it's been sitting in a bunker for 10, 20, even 50 years? Scientists at Los Alamos claim it will take a 10,000-fold increase in computing power to find out.
I was actually involved in the early days of ASC. It was an initiative at the time, started in 1996, and the goal was to develop modeling and simulation capability to support a move to no underground nuclear testing.
We've been in this business 70 years now, and we're entering a fourth era of computing technology. The first era was the serial era, where we'd run one code on one CPU. That was all that was in the machine. The next era was the vector era, which came with the craze, and where we could start breaking the problem up into little pieces, where we could run parts of it at a time, multiple parts of it at a time. With the ASCII program that started in 96 or so, we've started going to these commercial clusters and that we can buy mini processors and hook them together with networks. And then we're parallelizing the problem across thousands of processors. And now we're going to an era where that's going from thousands of processors to maybe a million or more. The Trinity shot was the first nuclear weapon, and the Trinity machine is the first advanced technology system. That's the beginning of this era of new types of machines. We don't even know the name for it at this point, this new era, because the technology is changing so fast on us. We've gone through many serial number one machines, and Trinity will be another one. It's exciting to bring up one of these machines and see the technology mature.
The Trinity test was obviously the culmination of the Manhattan Project. But the Trinity test itself, more than being just the culmination of one project, was one of the most significant scientific experiments of all time. It truly changed the course of history in a moment. Today, the laboratory is a very different place than it was during World War II. But at its heart remains world-changing innovation. We don't test nuclear weapons now, but we do maintain our stockpile using some of the most powerful computers in the world. Our new one, which is being built now, which we've named Trinity, is going to continue that legacy, that tradition of stockpile stewardship.